Merhabalar, yanımızda çok önemli bir konuğumuz var. Susan Stoutberg. Thank you so much for coming, Ms. Stoutberg. You are the co-founder of WCD, Women Corporate Directors. It's an amazing, beautiful institution with many accomplishments already and also many targets. What made you decide, what made you found this organization?
Well, 13 years ago, a couple of factors caused me to found Women Corporate Directors. The trouble I was having getting women even onto advisory boards, even getting people like Christine Lagarde when she ran a law firm onto a UN advisory board, and also having a safe haven where women could come talk about what questions could they really ask the auditing firm, what was the investment banker really up to, how do you handle chauvinism in the boardroom. So it started around my dining room table just 13 years ago, and now we have 2,000 members on 3,000 boards and 53 chapters around the world.
It's wonderful. And then we saw many chapters, as you said, all around the world. And most interestingly, it is also in Turkey. We just recently heard you, saw you, and also we recorded your launching the chapter in Turkey. What made you go to Turkey? Why Turkey, Ms. Stoutberg?
Well, Turkey is obviously one of the most important countries of the world right now. It's not just where the rivers and oceans come together, it's where the continents come together, it's where the trade routes are, and it's where bridges are built. And so Turkey is one of the most important countries we wanted to enter. We wanted to make sure that we had the top 50 women directors all invited and targeted. All we approached were very interested. All couldn't come that day, but they were all very interested in being involved because the Turkish women realize how important transparency is in corporations, and we see how important transparency is now in government too.
That's right. And what, may I ask you, what is next for WCD? I see there are so many demands that are coming from other world countries, even Muslim countries. In addition to that, what is next? What are your targets? And is it realistic to see really women playing an important role in the corporate room? Do you see it happening?
It's been slower than we would like, but there's a wonderful phrase actually came out of a Wellesley College study that one woman on the board is the invisible phase.
I like
that.
Two women
on the board is the conspiracy phase, but three women on the board is mainstream. And that's what we're trying to work on around the world. We've done studies on corporate governance. Catalyst, McKinsey, Credit Suisse have done studies, and they all show when you have three or more women on a board, the company performs better, the company's more involved in corporate responsibility, it promotes rising talents better. So it's so important to get more good quality people. That means multi-gender, multi-talented, multi-regional, multinational, multi-ethnic, multi-generational. You know, now the companies are bringing young people who understand technology, and they're going on the boards at 29 or 30 because they know high tech or digital technology.
And you mentioned earlier while we were talking outside, yes, there are calls that are coming from Iran,
yes,
from other Muslim
countries. Sudan. So but some of the Muslim countries are phenomenal leaders in this area. For instance, Malaysia several years ago created not a quota but a target that 30% of top government positions, board positions, and then also business positions had to be women. Instead of calling it a quota, which some people think is onerous, Malaysia called it a target, so the whole country can pull together and try to reach that target. So actually, Muslim countries are leading the world, not only having more women prime ministers than those of us in the West, but also going out and creating, you know, targets for better governance.
And are we going to see you back in Turkey again?
Yes, as a matter of fact, we not only we'll be expanding this, you know, this chapter, but the Dynamite Women in Turkey have already commenced this, and we're going to be having one of our institutes. We'll be taking one of our big institutes to Turkey probably in 2015. So we plan to bring women from all over the world who are all directors to Turkey.
Is your selection process criteria any different or difficult than, let's say, WPO, Women Present Organization?
Right.
How different are you?
Well, in the case of WCD, you need to be a corporate or a large family company director. WPO, for instance, helps entrepreneurs, and they have some women's companies who've gotten bigger. WCD is really for the women who are the global business elite, the women who are on boards. 85% are the women who are on these corporate boards or family boards. We take 15% who are people who are going to be on boards. They're either coming out of government, they are the corporate secretaries or general counsels who are working with the boards, or in some cases they're leading, you know, lawyers or accountants or executive search firms. You obviously want executive search firms as members of these organizations, because working with search firms, working with their own members, working with CEOs, WCD has gotten over 250 women onto boards and advisory boards around the world. That's what it's all about, getting women into the deal flow. You know, life is one big interview. And if you've got someone there being a sponsor for you, saying, here are the skill sets we need, supply chain, global branding, strategic talent, you find out, first of all, what the skill sets a company needs are. Then you say, I know a good woman for that slot.
And I'm very honored and blessed, actually, to have you, because you're also my colleague. And I'm honored because you are the first female correspondent. It's such a pleasure. I hope
it's an honor being here.
Thank you so much. Can you tell our audience about your experience as the first female being the correspondent, and what changed since then?
Well, it certainly changed a lot since then. When I started out as a television correspondent, a lot of men who are congressmen and senators didn't want to recognize you at a press conference or an interview. A lot of the news directors still have the casting couch. You know, you want to get a job and get to be in TV, here's the casting couch. But women journalists have been able to go out and be pioneers and get great stories. If you can get the great story, you can really sort of do the dig, then you can sort of do well. So I had a fascinating career covering the White House and Capitol Hill, and then was fortunate enough to be chosen as a White House fellow to go into the Ford White House and work first for Kissinger, the NSC staff, and then for Rockefeller as vice president. Mm,
thank you so much. Life is indeed a big interview, and thank you for giving me this pleasure. Thank you, Ms. Stoutberg.
Great to be here.